Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Chimeraland on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Chimeraland and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Chimeraland. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all my friends, the first thing to do is to launch our main browser. We selected the one we prefer. Let's go to the current URL I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you are able to see on the screen of the PC. You don't need to type it, simply because I added the clickable link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We landed on this page on the website of Usitility, in which we include a detailed information on how you can download Chimeraland on laptop or computer. We scroll lower a little bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on that link, we reach the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to enjoy the game Chimeraland on our PC. It is now obvious that we access several pros of running the emulator. Now we are on the way to start downloading the Chimeraland by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. The step is clicking on that button, and the download step takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to run the installer, so we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We answered yes. I minimize the web browser to find the installer significantly better. The installer is really easy to follow. It contains two choices, install and setup path. I will explain what setup path truly does. We just click on it, and we discover that we end up with here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be placed. If we want to vary this directory we must click on that browse option. Therefore we opt for another directory and install the emulator specifically where we desire. To keep it simple, just set it as it is. I simply click back, and I pick install. Now, there it is. The install begins and it's going to carry on along with the download of these MB which are shown on our computer screen. The time you save it on your machine, it could be more or less MB. The data transfer speed may go at a higher speed or at a lower speed, determined by your type of access to the web and according to the velocity of the emulator web servers. Right away they're going extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has actually been started immediately. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there's a progress bar that will move forward to the right then when it reaches the finish, the emulator is going to be launched for the first time. In reality the emulator is already started, here for the first time. Before we continue, as you understand, it has made two software icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is definitely the one we're concerned about. The moment we would like to operate Chimeraland on our laptop or computer, we double-click on that software icon and therefore run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's make the following step. That is a requirement, and which is to access the Google Play Store. And we'll mouse click on Play Store. As you can discover the Google Play is presented. At this point we must log on. At this moment the moment we're there, we have to conduct the following step that is mandatory. Therefore mouse click on Sign In. Now it announces Checking Info. It could in some cases get blocked in Checking Info, additionally it does not advance. If so, you should attempt to log in after a couple of hours and it will surely probably be solved. Now we shall provide our email and password. The email address must be a Gmail email address and its corresponding password. As an example, you make use of the same exact email you use right now in your own YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to type in my info and I'll go back immediately after I have done it. That's it, information typed in. And here is Google welcoming us and supplying us their terms of service. We should approve them by just clicking, I agree. Next, it allow us to save to the Google Cloud. You could let it select it and it will build a backup of the data files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it. You can utilize that option if you prefer. We click on accept. Google Play is started automatically and immediately. To set up the video game, we need to browse the Android emulator desktop by clicking on the app icon indicated green colored. Now that we are exploring the desktop of this Android emulator, we notice that we have now here the install application button. We click on this button. Here we access to the game app. Let's quickly simply click right here on the install button that I am just displaying now in green. And it will initiate the software installation. At present it would download on your laptop or computer and install the game app. It will take a while, or perhaps it could also be almost immediate. It again all relies on our internet access. It's already ended setting up. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this specific button that I'm showing in green, in order to start Chimeraland for the first time. We are at present on the emulator desktop, then we're preparing to simply click this brand new Chimeraland app icon that has been provided. The Android game is started for the first time. Now there we end up with it. I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will talk about the volume level of this emulator. It's right here. We have the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This way we will not use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. And to appreciate the experience to the maximum, we could switch on the large monitor, for which we have two choices. This is simply the first one. We mouse click on this particular app icon that I'm identifying in green. And the display screen is maximized, offering one border on top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. In case we aspire to run the video game using all the screen, we click this game icon. And we might presently be experiencing the game app in 100% screen mode. To quit the 100% screen mode, just click the F11 key. And we might now end up being in regular display mode. Now I am ready to demonstrate you the computer keyboard mapping that is definitely very helpful. This way we definitely will be ready to play the game application much more easily. The first point is to click on this application icon. It's now time to get the required configuration settings. I can leave the standard configuration, but if you intend to improve this, you may very well achieve it without any problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. Occasionally it occurs that your emulator is launched in the improper language, as an example, in Chinese. And consequently to set it up in the proper language we browse here to the cogwheel. And right here inside of additional options, we click that language drop down. We can select the language we prefer, English, Mandarin, and so forth. As soon as the language is determined, we should save, the emulator would reboot, along with the game, next time we start it, will of course be in the preferred language. At this moment, you will find another information that we will need to take into consideration, and this is that we will receive a message from Google Mail telling that a new electronic device has been connected with this Google account. It will likely question us if we are the individuals who have connected that device. That's right, we ought not be troubled, considering the fact that emulator is behaving like an Android electronic device. And to identify which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we go right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. And we browse here to the model choice. And right here we determine that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for our training. I anticipate you appreciated it, especially that everyone found it useful. If that is so, bring it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your feedback, concerns or suggestions, put them in the comment field down below. You could possibly also comment things on my Twitch channel, I do live streams every now and then, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Mouse click on any of these instructional videos which are usually showing up on the screen and let's have fun again in the upcoming instructional videos. Bye.